Good evening. I'm Nicholas Hoare for Vermont PBS. I'm holding in my hand a book which has become an African classic. And before the eyes glaze, I should point out that this is anything but what you think it might be. It is the story of an infamous murder which took place in Africa, in Kenya, at the height of the Second World War in 1941. On that occasion, in the middle of the night, a body was found belonging to the Earl of Erroll, Josslyn Hay, on a crossroads outside Nairobi with a bullet in his head. In the brouhaha that erupted as a result, Sir Jock Delves Broughton was hauled in for questioning by the police and subsequently arrested on suspicion of being the murderer. In the trial that subsequently ensued, it became very clear that he, and indeed many another gentleman, could have been the perpetrator, given the fact that Josslyn Hay was a notorious rake who had not only made off with Broughton's own wife, but had made off with many another wife as well, with the result that in the courts of law, the entire gaudy tale was peeled back like the proverbial orange, revealing for all to see, and they were fascinated, what was going on in the Kenyan highlands in what was known as Happy Valley. Happy Valley was anything but, to some degree. It was spoilt, it was pampered, and it was a closed society filled with aristocrats of all descriptions, of immense wealth, with an immense ability to self-indulge. And these two gentlemen, one dead, one still alive, triggered what became a social time bomb. The story, which is absolutely riveting, was exposed bit by bit by a gentleman called Cyril Connolly. And Cyril Connolly, before he died, had worked with this author, James Fox, to compose a very famous article that ran one occasion in the Sunday Times in London. As a result, the story made headlines, not just in that paper, but across the country. And as a result of that, in turn, legend became myth. The story of what James Fox and Cyril Connolly before him unearthed is the purpose of this book. And it started a trend. As you can see behind me, there are three other books, and there are others as well, which were spawned from this particular title's success. One of which is called The Ghosts of Happy Valley by one Juliet Barnes, which brings the story of Happy Valley, which is actually not a happy story, up to date. The second, which is much more interesting in my opinion, is called The Temptress, which is the scandalous life of Alice de Jansey, a lady of dubious reputation herself, who managed to shoot and maim her own lover in Paris before consorting with, guess who, Delves Broughton. So, you have the third book, which is called Child of Happy Valley, a memoir written by Juanita Carberry, and she, bless her, has a savory reputation and should not be cast in the same light as everybody else. So you have a cross-representational view of high society in African terms in a way that you're unlikely to see anywhere else. But the book that started it all is White Mischief. It is a delight from start to finish. It's extremely naughty. It's very speculative. It's extraordinarily exciting and very well written. And on that mischievous note, good evening.